good.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Johnson Sports Center here on the campus of Northwest Nazarene University. And we are set to rejoin Great Northwest Athletic play tonight as the Northwest Nazarene University men's basketball team hosts the Seattle Pacific Falcons to get things rolling again here in the new year. I'm Craig Stensgaard, joined by Kerry Cook, as always. And Kerry, they've each had a couple warm-up games, and now it's time to go back to what counts.
Yeah, back to business. Got two teams tonight that are very well matched up. If you look at records, they're very similar. SPU has had some really good wins on the season, and NNU has had some really good wins on the season. SPU comes in to play tonight in the GNAC at 1-1, and NNU's at 2-0, and so it's going to be a fun matchup.
Seattle Pacific has won four in a row coming into tonight, as they had a pretty successful December, late December, while your Nighthawks have won back-to-back games against Westmont down in California, which any road win is a great win. And that was, to me, that one was significant because it was a single-game road trip. They flew down, played the game the next day, took care of business, came home.
The good part is, on a trip like that, it's really hard to get motivated for one game, and then it's so ugly down there, it's easier to get motivated.
yeah, nothing to look at. There's no
right.
Pacific Ocean. It was not.
No.
It wasn't 65 to 70 degrees or
right.
anything like that.
But right.
Yeah, that's. I felt really bad for the boys heading down there in the middle of December. Well, the Falcons, they have, like I said, they have won four straight. They have wins over their last GNAC win was over Alaska Anchorage, and then they defeated Douglas College out of Canada, the same Douglas that the Nighthawks beat last week, and then a win over Linfield, and then a really good D2 win over Cal State San Marcos. So coming into tonight, both teams have primed the pump, and they're ready to roll.
They are. You know, take a look at Seattle Pacific and some of their leading players. Shaw Anderson comes in with 21.3 points a game. If you look at his statistics, he is an incredible shooter. He's average, or he's 50% from the field this year, 31% from three-point line, and then a 91.4% free throw shooter. So that he is by far their leading scorer. And then Julian Mora and Trace Evans are following him with 12 points and 11 points. And so, you know, that'll be a focus for Coach Hawkins. Julian Mora, who's the second leading scorer, comes off the bench for them. So he probably leads that second unit, and it'll be fun to watch how they have their rotations tonight.
The Nighthawks have back at full strength tonight after missing a couple players the last time out. Biggie Bergeson is back in the starting lineup. And leading the way, third in scoring now at 11.8. But he and Allen and Murphy have kind of been the three barrels of the gun for the last 2 years for the Nighthawks. So it's nice to see all of them in double figures. Biggie's at 11.8 points a game, Cruz at 13.5, and then Gabe at 14.7.
Yeah, and you know, Jalen Fox is also, he didn't play against Douglas their last game, and he's back in the starting lineup as well.
Yeah.
Jalen's been one of those guys that when he's healthy, he always contributes. And he may not fill up the stat sheet, but he plays really solid defense. When he takes his shot, it's usually spot on. And he's just one of those glue guys.
Let's join our courtside announcer Tim Milburn for tonight's national anthem, invocation, and then the starting lineups. We'll be back after Tim.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We want to welcome you that have joined us here at the Johnson Sports Center, Orney Hill Center Court, the Nets for your Nighthawks. Tonight, NNU welcomes in visiting Falcons of Seattle Pacific University. We had the invocation and the playing of the national anthem prior to the previous game, and so we will go right into starting lineups, beginning with the Falcons. Starting at guard, 6-foot sophomore out of Seattle, Washington, number one, Owen Moriarty. Also at guard, a 6-6 sophomore out of Logan, Utah, number three, Jayden Pentagon. At guard, a 5-10 junior out of Seattle, Washington, number 10, Maui Zink. At forward, a 6-9 sophomore from New South Wales, Australia, number 14, Grace Evans. And at forward, a 6-7 senior from Kelso, Washington, number 24, Shaw Anderson. Let's make some noise as we tell you about the starters for your Nighthawks. Beginning at guard, 6-1 junior out of Boise, Idaho, number 0, Big E Ferguson. Also at guard, 6-1 junior out of Lapway, Idaho, number 1, Drew Allen. At guard, 6-2 senior from Las Vegas, Nevada, number 2, Jalen Fox. At Florida, 6-6 senior from San Diego, California, number 10, Christian Groves. And the big man, 6-9 senior out of Teresa, California, number 32, Dale Murphy. The Falcons are coached by Kevin Glasgow, assisted by Dallas Goldman and Chile and George Byer.
Your Nighthawks are coached by John Hawkins. Assisted by Kobe Terashima, Greg Marshall, Dave Roberts, and Ryland.
Well, I've already started off with a turnover tonight, Kerry. We didn't have any invocation or national anthem because they did it prior to the women's game.
That is true, but the truth is, you're such an honest guy, nobody else would have remembered that probably.
As you heard Tim announcing the starting lineups, you probably saw the camera angle. Of course, classes don't begin until Tuesday, so we're still without students here on campus for the break. So the local fans and kids that live close by that have come out will have to give enough support.
Everyone
for the Nighthawks
ready.
Here.
Nighthawk basketball is about to start.
It's always tough when you have home games over the break.
Yep.
And you lose that somewhat of that home court advantage.
Falcons with the tip. That was Anderson jumping against Gabe Murphy.
Falcons ball.
So nice defensive effort. Falcons with the basketball. That's Maui Z with running the point to start it off for Seattle Pacific. That's Z into the middle. Up and under, and that'll draw the travel. So a turnover on the Falcons. Gives it back to NNU. Drew Allen up top. On ball from Murphy. There's Jalen Fox. Takes it all the way down to the block. Big E now with 12 on the shot clock. Rotation, back cut. True Allen's going to hit the fadeaway from the corner. It's long, but an offensive rebound by Christian Rose, and he draws the foul.
That's good. Christian really read the ball on the shot really well and got great position there. Now he has an opportunity to go to the free throw line and put the Nighthawks on the board for the first point.
Owen Moriarty picks up the foul. First one is up and good.
It says Moriarty is listed as a 6'1 sophomore. He looks bigger than that.
He does. You're right. Here's Z over to Evans. Down the lane, misses the layup, Kind of a running tough layup by Penninger. Nice feed down to Rose. He's going to go one-on-one up with the left hand. Shot is blocked by Anderson, and then you will have it on the baseline. Oh, turnover. The zig and then the zag. So.
Yeah, and True is zagging and then zigging.
Yes. So they trade turnovers. Z will bring it up into the front court, guarded by True Allen. And then the Nighthawks steal it in the passing lane. Here's True Allen. Up, he's going to take it all the way up off the glass and miss. Good job defensively by Anderson to just keep his hands straight up. Three-pointer top of the key is short, pulled down by Rose.
You can see right off the bat, you don't want to leave Anderson wide open like that.
No, he is, like you stated earlier, 31% from the three-point line. Change of possession gives the Nighthawks a fresh shot clock. Gabe's working with Christian. Rose is going to go spin baseline, miss it long. Going to get a tip off of Gabe, so it'll be Falcons basketball. Nighthawks have had shots, but a couple of them not necessarily the advised effort. A little impatient early.
Mm-hmm.
It's a National League game tonight. It's 1-0. Here's Moriarty to the baseline. Oh, nice move. The step through, and he lays it in. True Allen. Short corner for Murphy. Murphy can go back to his right and shoot that jump hook. It's slapped out of his hand and stolen by Evans. And Murphy swims around the post. We're going to go out of bounds, so it's going to stay here with the Falcons as Christian Rose's shoulder was on the baseline. So good effort by
both teams.
In the new world we live in, where you can just wear whatever color you want to anytime, we've got red going against black now tonight instead of your home typical white uniforms. Foul's on True Allen. That's his first foul. We're going to have free throws now for Trace Evans. Evans has been really active, the 6'9", 245-pound sophomore out of Australia. Went to the University of Missouri, Kansas City, prior to transferring to Seattle Pacific. I don't know much about New South Wales, Australia, but it just sounds cool.
It does sound cool. I'm thinking about growing out the back of my hair, too.
Are you?
Yeah.
Going back to the 80s? If I had enough hair, I probably would, just because I could. Or probably not, because my wife would not put up with that. Murphy goes to work, misses the jump hook. Moriarty with the basketball. Gabe with Evans underneath. Good defense. Pick and roll on the skip. Good rotation. Backs Anderson wants a three, and it's off, tipped by
Aaron Murphy there.
Yeah. Biggie's going to go to work. Off the screen, pulls a three and misses it to the left side. Moriarty controls for SPU. Seattle Pacific coached by Kefri Fazio in his first year at the helm, as Grant Leap at the end of last year left to pursue an assistant's job at Seattle U. That'll take us to our first media break. It's 4-1. Not real high scoring here early, but we'll be back after the next 2 minutes.
First media timeout means we're giving away Nighthawks. Raise your hands, stand up, put your hands in the air.
Out of the break, Christian Rose leads your Nighthawks in scoring.
How many does he have, Craig?
One.
Oh, wow.
So, yep. That's they'll get warmed up here as we come out of the break. Onto the floor for Seattle Pacific is Kyle Lutinen. And a quick three-pointer, and he makes his presence known. Lutinen played 4 years at the University of Washington and is now at Seattle Pacific pursuing graduate studies. So he was able to take that COVID year, and now he's got one more year. There's Aaron Murphy. He's going to try to answer from the three-point line. It's off to the right. Rebound down to Lutinen. Evans faces up against Gabe Murphy.
There's a travel.
And then a block shot. Up and block shot again. Oh, now they're going to call a foul on True Allen. That'll be his second. That'll bring Ray Bergeson off the bench as he's got two quick ones here in the first little over 5 minutes. Evans is a 43% free throw shooter.
He was thinking back to the last game against Douglas and you played, Craig, that in some regards it's such a big step up from playing them to SPU that it takes a little while to adjust to the defensive pressure, the quickness, skill level, and nothing against Douglas at all.
No.
But they're just at a different level.
Yeah, different speed. There's Aaron Murphy. Gabe's going to work. Right-handed jump hook. The short. Rebound down to the Falcons.
Does feel like they are rushing their shots.
Yeah. Into the ball game was Yaru Harvey for NNU. There's a back cut and a block shot. Kicked out. A steal for Ray, but tipped out of bounds, and it'll stay with the Falcons.
Actually, tipped off of the official who was standing out of bounds.
Yeah, that's kind of bad luck. Theo McMillan with the basketball. Also checked in at the break. Evans with the roll down to the block. They double down. Three-pointers on the way, and it's short.
Good block out.
Rebound by Biggie. Over to Ray. Ray crosses it over to Aaron the screen. Biggie's got a lane. He's going to take it all the way in and lay it in. Lay it home. But we were at a nice angle from the press box. You could see the C's part right there.
Yep.
McMillan. Evans directing traffic. We're going to get an offensive foul. I think it might be on Anderson. We'll see here. No, excuse me. Jonas Latour. I didn't actually see where
I didn't see the foul
off the screen or what happened there.
Check it in. Christian Rose is back on the floor.
Gabe Murphy topside. Here's Yaru Harvey to the elbow. Rose ducks in on the weak side. There's Ray Bergeson with the three-pointer, and it's good.
Got his feet set nicely there, and that was good ball rotation by the Nighthawks with a good kick out. That inside-out game is something that Nighthawks love to do.
Off the screen, Anderson with a quick trigger. Another one. This one's an air ball pulled down and pushed by Ray. He's going to go to the left. Rose is going to get a quick post up. Nope, he releases. We've got Easton Reagan into the ball game. Here's the wraparound to Yaru. He's going to pick up the foul on the drive. We'll see if they'll get him on the floor or in action.
I think the second foul there on Jonas Latour. Nice head fake by Yaru Harvey there to have Latour close out and then timing was good on the dribble by.
Moriarty back into the ball game as Latour has picked up two fouls here in the last minute and a half. Here's Rose. Reagan with the basketball. Gabe Murphy pushed out. Back himself down. Another reaching foul. Yeah, that's the second one on Moriarty.
Personal foul. For one, Moriarty is second. Foul for four.
The flow of the game has ground to a halt here with all the whistles. Murphy up top, Easton. Harvey with five on the shot clock. Fade away, off the dribble, and it cradles home. And
that's his game right there. Yep. That couple of dribble pull up. So much more effective from that kind of a play for him.
Yaru has the ability to create offense all by himself. Nice rub screen there to get wide open at the post for the Falcons. There's Yaru, feeds it into Rose. Rose out to Ray with a three-pointer. It's long, ball's tipped around, grabbed by Lutonen.
SPU's done a great job so far blocking out Gabe Murphy, not allowing him to get any offensive rebounds.
Going to get a foul on Reagan. That was, I hate to say, I mean, that was bad luck. Everybody's feet got tangled up. He ended up as the guy on the top of the pile.
So yeah.
Therefore, it was his fault, right? Media break, 11:30 to go. Nighthawks have pulled to within three. They trail 8-11. We'll be back in 2 minutes. Basketball on the sideline out of the break.
Nice job of the Nighthawks to respond in that second 4 minutes. After being down 9-1, it's now 11-8.
Moriarty and Z back in the front court. Into the ball game. At the break is Schutterstedt. Off the back of the rim, rebound down to Aaron Murphy. Murphy at the high post, here comes, rolls all the way into the lane. Tough one off the back of the iron. Three-pointer on the way, and it's up and good for Nikias Schutterstedt. Reagan with the back cut, draws a double team. Yaru Harvey. Top side with Machado. Nice move by Easton. Reagan takes it off the dribble and pulls that defender away. Thompson with the basketball. Reagan comes into the backside. He's going to get whistled for the foul. Just a little late on the help side, but that's his second. Jalen Fox is up off the bench as Biggie was already at the scorer's table. So they'll pull Reagan out here with just 10 minutes left in the first half with two fouls. Anderson knocks home the first free throw.
Dave Murphy back on the floor for the Nighthawks. Trace Evans checks in for the Falcons.
Second free throw is also good. So Anderson knocks home as a 91.4% free throw shooter. That doesn't surprise any of us. Gabe Murphy now away from the double. Aaron Murphy, three-pointer from the corner, is up and good. So the Murphy brothers on both ends of that offensive play.
Yeah, and, you know, SPU has really made a concerted effort that when nice job by Biggie Bergeson to come over on the help side and be set, take that offensive charge.
I actually think he looked down at his feet.
He did.
Beforehand. Did I see that?
Yep.
Okay. To double check his heels weren't on that, weren't on the circle.
What I was saying is that SPU is making a concerted effort to really double down hard on Gabe Murphy. So if he can make some smart, quick decisions, find the open guy, that will really help the Nighthawks offensively.
Jalen Fox to the right side. Biggie squares up. Murphy high lows here. Oh, beautiful back cut by Ray. And Aaron delivers a spot on bounce pass. Nighthawks within one. Evans with the high screen.
Good communication there by Murphy.
Evans again. Yeah, foul on Gabe was kind of giving him the business there early. So, first foul.
Yeah, he got the lean going
Gabe,
there.
Gabe probably figures, hey, I'm 11 minutes into this thing and I don't have a foul. So, in my mind, I got one to burn.
Great minutes there by Ray Bergeson.
Oh, yeah.
He's huffing pretty hard coming out of the game.
Penninger back on the floor. Z looking for Anderson. Down to Evans. Got a travel on Evans as his reset dribble, I think, hit part of it, like his left foot a little bit, and it caused him to shuffle his feet. So a turnover. That's the fifth one of the ball game for Seattle Pacific. Nighthawks don't want to jinx anything, but they've only got two. Jalen Fox working hard and pulling the contact, pulling with his left hand and drawing the foul. So that's now six apiece.
Puts both teams in the bonus on the next foul.
Fox has a pretty significant size advantage against Z. Z's 5'10 and Fox is 6'2. Nice wrap around to Harvey. Harvey's going to take it. Now right there with the jump hook. Oh, in and out for Gabe Murphy.
That was actually a really good look, especially as the shot clock was running down.
Tell you what, last Saturday, he could not miss that shot. Of course, he was being guarded by someone 6 feet tall, but, you know.
Good close out there on Lutonen.
Fox, nice job breaking down the defense there. Biggie going to work off the screen. There's the roll. Nobody stops him, so he'll take it all the way. Oh, Gabe Murphy with a great offensive rebound. Then it goes off the hands of Evans. So it'll be Nighthawks basketball after we come out of the Knicks media break. And then you, SPU, in a good battle, 15-16. We'll be back in 2 minutes.
Here they come. It's time for the Dizzy Bat Race. We're going to use a bat. We're going to get them dizzy, and then they're going to race. On your marks. Get set. Go. Go. Spin around those bats. Congratulations. Our winner tonight receives a Domino's pizza.
Nighthawks on the baseline out of bounds. Jalen Fox into Biggie. They'll reset from the top. Fox into the elbow. Biggie comes off the screen. Three-pointer.
Oh, in and out. Oh, man.
Chance for the Nighthawks to regain the lead. They led for about a minute at 1-0. So. Evans going to go one-on-one against Murphy. Spins baseline up under. Nice move. But a block shot by Yaru Harvey from the backside. Great help defense. Biggie sets up the screen. Fox cuts through. Floater with the left hand off the back of the rim.
Nice. I like the quick move, though.
Rebound by Penninger. Looking for that baseline move. Here's, oh, ball's tipped away, and a steal for the Nighthawks. Great job by Yaru Harvey. He's had his hands on the last two possessions defensively. Fox over to Biggie. Aaron Murphy with the ball on the baseline. He's going to square up on Evans and take him to the rack. Up, left hand, float, misses the floater.
Would have been an easier shot had his glasses not fallen
off.
Yeah,
that's true. Penninger all the way down the lane, but we had a black. Oh! A late whistle. So we got a shooting foul against Yaru Harvey. That's the old, he missed the shot, therefore a foul will be called. I think if that one would have gone down.
It looked like, man, they didn't call it.
Yeah.
And then it looked like the elbow really caught the chops of Yaru Harvey.
Yeah, yeah. In fact, did you? I don't know if you just noticed the off official was talking to Yaru. I think he, and it appeared it was a positive conversation. It was not a. Free throw. For Penninger is up and good. So a 2-point game. Biggie directs traffic. Skip past Yaru into the lane. Vacates the key, 7 on the shot clock. Here's a screen. Biggie's looking for the baseline, fade away. Oh, great read by Gabe Murphy.
That was, I'm gonna give Biggie an assist.
Yeah, exactly. There's no pictures in the book.
You're exactly right though, Craig. He really read that well and knew he had to get it up quick. The shot clock was running out.
Luton Evan Z with the three-pointer. We're going to get a tip by off the hand. I think Biggie got a little piece of it.
I think the people on the front row over there would disagree with
really?
That.
Really? They had a pretty good view. Quick catch and shot for Lutinen, pulled down by Ray. He's going to push it. Murphy's with great post position all the way up. And, oh, no, off the back of the rim. Another quick three. This one's short. That's by Penninger.
They're not afraid to shoot it.
No. We're tied at 17. Aaron Murphy tonight just rushing it just a little bit with the basketball. Biggie off the screen. It's going to be short. Rebound down to Evans. I wonder if there's a fan on today. Everybody's just a little bit short.
Well, there's one on each end.
Oh, there we go. Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, those shots are looking a lot the same. There's Luton into the corner. Penninger going to drive it in. We're going to get an offensive foul as Ray Bergeson this time draws the charge. That was a good read.
It was a really good read.
That's going to take us to our final media break of the half. We're tied at 17. We'll be back after this. Ball. Christian Rose back onto the floor, as is True Allen. And Gabe Murphy. Zone look here for the Falcons. Christian Rose just goes right at it.
Yeah, they got the ball short corner and were able to break the middle of the zone.
Evans does not have a foul, but Rose went right after him, and he kind of played him like he had fouls. So that might be a nice block by both Gabe and the rim. And he throws it up, and it goes in.
Trace Evans, 2 points.
Fox all the way through. Floater over to Ray. 15 on the shot clock. Drew comes off of two screens. The elbow jumper is good. Boy, that was a nice shot out of the system right there.
That sure was.
Under 3 minutes to go. Nighthawks now back on top. Lutinen with the three, missed. Rebound down to Murphy. Elbow again, jumper this time short. Evans looking for a guard. There he's got Anderson. Anderson at the top. Nice screen. Anderson's going to take it down the middle of the lane. Lutinen with the floaters. Tipped and missed. Rebound down to Ray. Push to True Allen. Jump stop. Good choice.
Yeah, I was nervous he was going to take it in there and pick up his third foul.
Yeah. Oh, nice work by Yaru Harvey. Capitalized on his quickness and just beat him to the rim. 4-point lead now for the Nighthawks, largest of the night. Christian Rose.
Christian doesn't like the call, but I thought it was a good call.
Yeah. Evans was a good pickup for the Falcons. He's just a sophomore. So he only spent 1 year at UMSL. Excuse me, UM Kansas City. Had St. Louis in my head. Free throw up and good. The real question when Anderson shoots the free throw at that high of a percentage is, will we witness one of his misses this year?
That is a good question.
Because he is one of those kids that will probably go through the year and only have maybe 20 misses for the year. And that is 100% a compliment.
Timeout on the floor.
Did we, 30-second timeout? Yeah, 30-second timeout. You know, a guy who averages 21 points usually figures out a way to get there. So it's like he may just go on an absolute tear in the second half. So Nighthawks with the basketball, minute 22 to go. Yaru Harvey left side, Aaron Murphy with the post against Evans. Nice ball movement as they're back to only had that one possession of zone. True Allen, floater in the lane, is missed. Rebound down to Evans. Lutinen.
1 minute.
Back to Z. Z's going to attempt to go underneath. And we're going to get a missed layup by Evans and a rebound on the back.
Got a little too far under the hoop there.
Lutinen with the steal. He's a big kid to go over at 6'7", long arms.
Timeout called by the Falcons.
30-second timeout called by Coach Fox. turnover will enable NNU to get the final shot if they so choose. And it looks like that's what Coach Hawkins wants as the Nighthawks lead it by two here with 13 seconds to go.
Looks like a 1-2-2 zone here.
That is a good defensive switch there. I'm going to get the kick. So we've got 5.0 to go. Quick substitution brings Latour back in. Another smart thing there. Gets Evans off the floor. No need for another foul.
Same with Yaru Harvey, yep, who has two fouls.
Yep. So Aaron Murphy. Here comes Jalen Fox. Biggie's going to try and bank one in. Misses off the dribble. Your halftime score, 23-21. Nighthawks by two as we take it into the break. We'll take our own break here and be back at the end of the first half as we get set for our second half of basketball here in tonight's GNAC action. We're glad we enjoyed the holidays, but hey, it's good to be back and into league play. as we wind down here at the half. Scoring for the Nighthawks, very spread out. Of course, 23 points, not a lot to spread out. Five for Ray Bergeson, three for Murphy, three for Christian Rose, four for Yaru Harvey. Same on the other side for the Falcons. 6 points leads the way for Anderson, as he is all from the free throw line, six of six, and he has a couple of rebounds. Evans has done the most work on the glass. He's got 6 rebounds to lead all players, while Aaron Murphy's got 3. Ray Bergeson's got 4, and Gabe Murphy has 3. So coming out of the break, it will be Nighthawk basketball to get us off and rolling. Coach John Hawkins' team breaks the huddle, and we are set as they return to the starting lineup of Biggie Bergeson, True Allen, Jalen Fox, Christian Rose, and Gabe Murphy. Seattle Pacific will also return to their starters with Moriarty, Penninger, Z, Evans, and Anderson.
Nighthawks have the ball.
Here's True Allen putting it into play. Man-to-man defense. Start out again for the Falcons. Fox comes off the dribble with the floater. A little bit strong off the back of the iron. Evans one-on-one against Gabe. Murphy does a nice job staying down. Kicks it back out to Anderson. SPU ball in front of their own bench. Z will take it. Out of bounds. Z played at Bellevue College prior to Seattle Pacific. He's a Washingtonian from Roosevelt High School. Off the dribble. Oh, Evans with a nice offensive rebound. Stole it away from Jalen Fox and Gabe Murphy. Got the fresh 20-second reset. Z calls his own number from a long ways out. Rebound down to Jalen. Rose is going to go to work against Anderson. Baseline up, off the glass. Nope, missed. Rebound down to Z. Moriarty off the dribble. Back to Anderson. Three-pointer is up and good. SPU takes a one-point lead. Nice screen by Gabe Murphy. And True Allen's able to shake it past Evans.
He did a really nice job of getting in the lane there and then giving a little shimmy. Was able to shoot it with nice touch over Evans.
Moriarty is going to get called for that hook pretty soon. Next one that he does that, he'll get called for the hook. As he hooked Jalen pretty hard 2 times. Gabe Murphy keeps himself under control and then draws the foul on. Actually, it's going to be on Z. So,
team foul number one.
Got the reach.
Murphy at the line. 2 shots.
Looks like the Nighthawks did a really nice job on Anderson the first half. Mm-hmm. SPU did a great job on Murphy in the first half. He only had 2 shot attempts. Kept him away from the hoop, doubled hard.
Murphy's a 71% free throw shooter. Which come playoff time, that is huge. Second free throw is also good. The last two or three years as the Nighthawks have made playoff runs, that free throw shooting by Gabe has been a big deal. Evans skip pass to Moriarty. Two-man game up top. 10 on the shot clock. Ooh, Fox almost got that one. Z with the step back three.
And he calls. No.
And he makes that, and then
And then was
sure,
really happy with himself.
I'm not sure what that little animation was, but
he's really happy.
Yeah. True Allen answers with a quick bucket on the other end, and we're tied up at 29. Z's trapped in the corner. Evans turns, skips, Anderson. All the way around, three-pointers on the way, and it's good for Jaden Penninger.
So the three-point, yeah, the three-point shots that were not falling in the first half,
yeah,
so far here in the first 3.5 minutes of this half, they are falling for Seattle Pacific.
Including one blind one. Biggie into the corner. High post.
How about the two hands?
Fox is able, or True Allen's able to, yeah, recover from the reach, but misses the three. Pretty early in the shot clock for that three-pointer. He'll probably make that adjustment. Biggie steals it as he's, Penninger's going up. That's his, he's got a couple steals tonight. Oh, yeah, okay. Gabe Murphy with the push off. Had both hands on his back. And a little acting.
Yeah, Aaron, he went down pretty quick for a
yeah,
big guy.
That's what I mean. Aaron Murphy and Yaru Harvey are coming into the basketball game, and that's going to burn our first media timeout. 15:34 to go. Nighthawks trail by three. We'll be back. Seattle Pacific basketball out of the break. Nighthawks looking to extend pressure. Gonna go to, you're gonna trap Z.
SPU's done a nice job off of that trap here in the second half.
Mm-hmm. Evans face up. Nighthawks are playing off of Evans very deep. Has not at least been a threat from the outside. So they're keeping Gabe down in the key for the help side defense. Here's True Allen, finds Aaron Murphy. Gabe at the high post, goes down to the low post, turns it over as Anderson swims around, gets a hand on it for the steal. Third turnover for the Nighthawks tonight. Anderson off the screen from Evans. Quick three again by Z. And it is off the back of the rim. So we didn't get the animation there. Here comes Biggie. Finds True Allen down to Gabe. Gabe spins baseline side. Back to True. True, one step up. Short corner jumper is good for True Allen. Give Gabe Murphy that assist.
Yeah, that was nice job. Triple team that time on Gabe Murphy. And the defender flew out at True, and he just took that one dribble pull-up. He, like Harvey, that's more of their game than True three-point shooters.
Nice defensive work. Oh, and he gets hammered by Z. Nope, they're going to give the foul to Penninger. Substitutions for NNU. Machado is into the ball game. Luton is in, as is Schoenerstedt and... who did I miss? Latour is back. Comes Ray. Ray and Biggie play catch up top. Machado.
Hey, look at that. He accidentally wore different shoes again.
Ray Bergeson goes in amongst the trees, and Anderson's able to get a hand on it. So it's a block shot out of bounds. 10 on the shot clock. Here comes Biggie around quickly into Machado. Machado does a nice job of keeping his composure. Ray takes one at the end of the shot clock and knocks it home. Ray Bergeson squares it up and knocks it home.
Fun to see him play with some confidence on the offensive end. He not only runs the team well, but he's shooting the ball pretty well the last few games.
34-32 NNU. Lutonen in the corner. Z's able to sneak through as they vacated the post and really ended that set in a five out. 34-34. Biggie one-on-one against Luton. Down screen for Machado. Murphy squares up. 15-footer is good for Aaron Murphy. Caught Anderson with his hands down.
Does make the shot easier.
Yaru, Anderson, little shoulder bump. It's really a nice play is what it is.
Really nice play.
It's just, yep, you did use your shoulder, and yep, it came off perfect, you know?
Yep.
Yaru Harvey into the lane, elevates, misses the four-footer. Probably eight-footer, sorry. Three-pointer from the top of the key is short. Tipped out of bounds by Latour. And that'll take us to the 11:27 media break. It's tied at 36. We got a good one here in Nampa. We'll be back. Christian Rose, True Allen back into the game. Second half shooting percentages have picked up for both teams. 45.5% for NNU, 54% for Seattle Pacific. Oh, Yaru Harvey with a great cut to the basket.
Yeah, and a good soft pass there by Gabe Murphy in traffic.
So Yaru will go to the free throw line. That's the third foul on Seattle Pacific this half, just one on NNU. Harvey's first free throw is good. Yaru on the season is a 90% free throw shooter. He was coming into tonight, was 9 of 10. He's played in all 10 games for the Nighthawks.
And as the season has progressed, his play has really been a big factor and been a really nice contributor, especially as the season has worn on.
Nighthawks have 5 players that have played in every game this year. Their depth is a definite asset. Here's McMillan with the basketball. 10 on the shot clock. Harvey was able to, at least, he might not have deflected that, but he caused a tough catch. Long offensive rebound by Latour. Latour, one dribble in with the jumper, is good.
Nice move there by Latour.
Latour is from the peninsula and went to North Kitsap High School.
Theo McMillan with the foul there as True Allen was trying to cut through the lane.
Baseline out of bounds. Allen will take it out for the Nighthawks. They'll stretch it across the baseline. The wraparound. Allen gets all the way to the rim. Oh, but misses the shot. The finger roll from point blank.
Everything but the finish right there.
He's just shaking his head. He's like, wait a minute.
Everything but the finish.
I'm sure it felt great. He was so... His hand was, I think, back of his hand was on the rim. Nighthawks pressure is helping. We've talked about this many times, but you know that pressure isn't necessarily meant to get a steal. I mean, they'd love to get a steal, but the real focus of that pressure is more to steal 6 seconds off the shot clock.
That make the team uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And so it's harder to get into your offensive rhythm.
Absolutely. And it's producing exactly what they want. And they've gotten a couple steals out of it. And definitely disrupted the ease of just walking it up the floor.
And SPU has more size. So if you can put pressure on the wing guys, it's much more difficult to get the ball inside.
Under 10 minutes to go. Tied at 38. True Allen guarded by Moriarty. Back to Rose. Rose gets Biggie loose up top. Anderson switches out on him. Reset with 15. Allen hard up the lane, and he draws the foul. I thought he might have short-armed that, but I think he got hit. That's why it came across.
Got displaced a little bit and was actually farther away from the hoop than when he thought he was actually going to be.
Exactly. When he started to float, there wasn't a breeze that hard enough to push him across the lane. So Allen's first free throw is up and good. Evans with the rebound. Harvey nearly snuck around him for that one. Anderson, left side. Here's Evans one-on-one against Murphy. Murphy does a nice job staying down. His hands were down around his waist, and I think that's the part that Gabe wants to know, what am I supposed to do?
Yeah, that's kind of a, it's almost like he's got to give it, that call is there telling him, yeah, the cylinder, giving him space. But, man, when you're getting battery rammed down there.
Well, and it's like the first hour of basketball camp, there was like 19 pivots going on. Here's Evans at the top against Aaron Murphy. Same thing here. Here we go again. It's going to be the same. But Murphy gets his hand in there, pushes it away. Yeah, he did hook him, and it'll be the same thing at the other end as what we were talking about earlier in the half, or in the first half. So,
yeah, Coach Hawkins is not happy because it's been happening.
Yeah,
The game, and then
that's true.
They randomly call it. I shouldn't say randomly, it happened.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll probably see it again here. Evans. Moriarty. Two-man game. Luton and quick three, it's good. That is not the shot you want to give up because that he has a quick trigger and a good-looking stroke for the 6'7 big man. Timeout on the floor called by Seattle Pacific. They're going to stretch it to a full. We'll take it as well. Nighthawks trail by two. We'll be back. Nighthawks basketball out of the break. Christian Rose, True Allen, Yaru Harvey, Biggie Bergeson, and Aaron Murphy on the floor for the Nighthawks. Allen gets knocked off the dribble, draws a foul on Moriarty. That is the sixth foul. So the next one, Nighthawks will be in the bonus. NNU only whistled for three fouls. So that will be careful for the Nighthawks, as I'm sure that will be fixed. Oh, the floater again.
He really squared up nicely on that one as well.
That was a really nice. So the steal and then the foul.
That's going to be four, I believe.
On Moriarty?
On Moriarty.
Wow.
That's a big call there.
Yeah, it is. And this will take us to our under 8-minute media break. So the Nighthawks will be at the free throw line with a chance to tie it when we come back.
Yaru Harvey at the line, shooting
1-1. Yaru Harvey's at the line, shooting 1-1 after that fourth foul on Moriarty.
Team fouls are at 7-3, so we'll have to, Nighthawks do need to be careful because understandably the officials will, that will get pointed out to them.
I believe it was at that last timeout.
Yes, yes. And if you're on the other end of that.
Absolutely.
You feel the same way. So Nighthawks extend that pressure to full court now. As we're tied at 41 after Yaru knocks them both home. And Aaron Murphy had the steal and then slipped. And he lays there for a minute to stare at the ceiling because he's
just
not
gather
happy.
Himself.
He's not happy.
Check his thoughts.
And I understand. Now he's looking back like, what in the world? As the officials and the players were clearing the floor and they give him a chance to clean his glasses off. And here's Z with the basketball. Penninger in the front court. Z to the baseline. Oh, beautiful find by Evans, who got the jump stop. The crowd wanted to travel.
Multiple jump stops.
Yeah. There's Biggie, top of the key. Yaru Harvey quickly down to Aaron Murphy. Murphy's going to go to work against Evans. Jump hook with the right hand is good for Aaron Murphy. Nighthawks back in the lead. Screen exchange for Anderson.
Wow.
And then Christian Rose is called for the foul. Coach Hawkins wants to know what he did. But what I will tell him what he did is it was the contact play and there were only three fouls called on NNU. So they've got to be careful. Like I said, they've got to be careful. Anderson. He had the mismatch. I'm not sure why he didn't go after.
Gave up that dribble.
Yeah. Interesting. Over the top side. Z with the ball into Evans. Murphy with Evans. Tough shot by Penninger.
Thought it was down.
Yeah. Lob pass into Murphy. Good catch by Murphy. It's going to be a 1-1. Foul is going to go on Lutner.
Personal foul. Call it Falcons number two. Second, team foul, eight.
That brings Schoonerstedt back onto the floor.
Schoonerstedt checks in for the Falcons. Dave Murphy.
Schoonerstedt is from Vienna, Austria.
Craig, have you ever been to Vienna, Austria?
I was just going to ask if you've been to Vienna.
I have.
I think you have. Yeah, I have not.
A couple of times, and it's one of the most beautiful places in the world.
Yeah. I see. Looks like we've got blood on the floor, so they're going to send the players to the bench while
the blood crew comes out.
The blood crew comes out. Someone's dripping because they keep finding more. So let's see.
They're trying to see, look at elbows and see who's.
Oh, yeah. I don't think they've had, they identified where.
No.
Huh. It may have come out of their mouth or something.
Yeah, it may be Anderson here.
Oh, okay.
He hit it well from the officials.
Yeah, he did.
Because they specifically went over and
Looks like it might be on a hand. So hopefully that'll stop bleeding for him. Gabe Murphy at the line, one plus the bonus, as that was the eighth team foul on the Falcons.
Yeah, the only real foul trouble on either team is Moriarty with four.
Here's Z against Ferguson. Nice job by Murphy to keep it on the ground. Might be 3 seconds here pretty soon. Nope, turned it over, picked it up by
That's great defense.
Drew Allen.
Would you have pictured Gabe Murphy doing that when he came in as a freshman?
Man. You talk about the growth and maturity. It's been so fun to watch. You know, I mean, like I said, he's the mayor of NNU.
Yeah, he really is.
He just loves it here.
And he's loved here.
NNU loves him back. I mean, it's one of the main reasons we got Aaron. You know, just
absolutely.
The experience that Gabe has had at NNU. There's True Allen. Gets down the left side of Main Street and lays it in. Nighthawks back to four. That's the largest lead of the night. It matches about 8 minutes ago. Nice trap. Ball's swatted free. Anderson takes a quick three. He misses it. Biggie hustles for it. Goes off. I think that's actually SPU ball.
I do too. Biggie threw it off.
I think
he threw it off of SPU, but yeah. It bounced back and hit SPU, or hit Biggie as he was laying out of bounds.
That's a really good call. Yeah, you're right. We had a good view of it from our spot. Perched high above the court of Orney Hill Center Court, or at least 12 feet.
I mean, if I was down by that official, I'd tell him, why are you calling that from across the floor? But I'm up here.
He actually did have the right angle.
It was the right call.
The real question is why they got 20 on the shot clock, though. That seems, I'm not certain, unless they deemed there was a possession change. But even then, I think it goes to the full. It would go to the full. So I don't know. We won't have an opportunity to ask them. But
Coach Fazio is asking,
yeah.
Why is that not a full shot clock?
Right, exactly. Lutonen. Into Z. Ferguson, nice job. We've got the point guards going into work at the block. So off the hand of True Allen. Now we're at 11 on the shot clock. Lutonen's going to come off that screen. There's the double. They tried to close the gate on him. Anderson one-on-one against Rose. Good defense and tough shot. Boy, that looked like it was all the way down.
Yeah, that was like three quarters of the way in.
Man. Under five to go. Tell you, these home GNAT games are so
critical.
So important to win. There's a reach, maybe the ninth foul.
If you want a chance at the postseason, you have to protect your home court at all. You know, at all costs, and then steal a couple on the road.
Yeah. Biggie Bergeson shooting the free throws. Here comes Yaru Harvey. Going to give Ray
Yaru
a break.
Harvey back on the floor for NNU.
Missed the free throw. Rebound down to Lutonen. Good work by Moriarty out to Lutonen.
Wow, tough shot there.
He knocks it home. I don't think that was a flop at all. I think he got his foot, like he might have hit his own foot or the floor. Nighthawks by one. Aaron Murphy, short corner against Anderson. He goes baseline up and back around and misses. the finger roll. Under four to go. Gonna let Z play. Here's Anderson. Double team on Anderson. Ball's loose, kicked around. Oh, it's gonna be an over and back as Aaron. I'm not certain how that can be. Well, it's because Aaron touched it first. If Aaron would have seen that SPU touched it, he would have not, because it would have been an automatic over and back.
Mm-hmm. But you gotta love the hustle.
You gotta go, yeah. Yeah. 3:35 to go in the ball game. Break the huddle as NNU holds a slim one-point lead.
Yeah, it's SPU ball after that jump ball and good hustle by both teams.
Luton, and obviously playing 4 years at University of Washington, has got a ton of age and experience, right? So it's Moriarty, two on the shot clock. Long three-pointer is missed. Rebound by Aaron Murphy.
Guess I didn't realize the shot clock didn't reset. Maybe that's what the officials were talking about.
Yeah, and location. Oh, and Aaron Murphy with the offensive follow. Was that Murphy? Or?
That was Murphy.
Yeah, okay. I know both of them came out, rose with their hands up.
I'm going with Aaron Murphy because
okay.
Tim Milburn called
it.
Oh,
he did? Okay,
yeah.
Well, that's all that matters. So, Lutonen over to with Anderson. Pinniger. Moriarty calls his own name from the corner. He misses long. Rebound down to Aaron. You know, Kerry, with two sets of brothers on the team in all the years, I generally don't refer to players by just for their first name. But the Nighthawks fans, I think by now, have figured out that those four kids, the Bergeson brothers and the Murphy brothers, are pretty much first name guys for me. Christian Rose battled for that offensive rebound and got a fresh 20 on the shot clock.
Good decision by Harvey.
Man.
Back that back out.
That was a men's basketball rebound right
there.
Yeah,
and then the tip out by Bergeson was huge.
Here's Harvey. Oh, rotation. Bergeson catches it, shoots it, long. Oh, off. Oh, good job, Aaron. He wanted to slam that ball to the ground. And
wow.
He's called for the rebounding foul. Christian Rose is having a little question and answer session with the official.
Man, that's rough.
Aaron's got to be careful. He's drawing a little attention to himself right now, so he's doesn't want to pick up a technical that could be costly. Luton in with the on-ball screen as they try to break the pressure. They do. Up and good for Moriarty. 1 point game now, 1:40 to go. Two fouls to give still before the Falcons are in the bonus. True Allen, oh, got the lane, got the contact, but he laid it in and it's good. 3 point lead for the Nighthawks. Nighthawks bench trying to provide the energy. Here's Lutonen. Anderson faces up on Christian Rose. Into the lane. Going to get a foul and misses the shot. So it's a two free throw, two shot foul. Will we witness one of Anderson's misses?
That's a good question. And the way they've looked so far tonight, I'm going to say no.
I don't know if he's hit the rim yet. I mean, to be honest, yeah, that didn't hit the rim. That's just pure as it is, boy. Murphy, Gabe Murphy, Biggie Bergeson back in for the Nighthawks. Here comes Trace Evans.
Trace Evans.
Now.
We found the culprit.
Oh, we did?
Of the blood.
Oh, who is that?
That is Shaw Anderson. He's asking for some tape.
Yeah, he needs to get it's on his hand. That's where it's been coming from. So we're take a medical break here. I don't know what I think they give him like a minute or two to so Todd's gonna get him taken care of. You know, the one thing that people don't realize in the GNAC is because of budgets and the travel schedules and everything, not every team is able to travel with their own athletic trainer.
Right.
So one thing that happens behind the scenes that not very many people know is that we all take care of each other's players.
Mm-hmm.
And our trainers are taking as best care as they can of their kids, just like they do. The trainers really don't care whose uniform it is, you know.
Right.
And it's universal. I mean, when we go to Seattle Pacific, Western, I mean, it doesn't matter where we're going. We're getting very good care by the other teams as well. And that's one thing I'm not going to say it's unique because that's trainers all over, they're going to take care of any kid they can. You know, but I know that the trainers in the GNAC, they work together really well, and they have summer meetings together. Of course, COVID kind of blew up the face-to-face meetings. Prior to COVID, all the trainers would meet every summer face-to-face, but they communicate constantly, and it's all behind the scenes. No one knows it's happening. During the week, the trainers will get an email early in the week from the opponents letting them know, hey, these are the kids and here's the injuries they're struggling with. And they're getting treatment from the visiting trainers, hopefully just as good a quality as if they're at home. So.
Well said, Craig.
Thanks. Good shout out to those guys. NNU's head trainer Jamie May, and you've got Todd down there on the floor.
He's even
tonight.
Cleaning the basketball.
Yeah, he cleaned the basketball off too. Anderson's making a mess out there. Get some more. Few more spots. Looks like we're good to go. That will put Anderson at the free throw line. free throws now. May need to warm up again. It's been a long break. Shoot a couple layups.
If he misses, he iced himself because it was his finger that was bleeding.
The other thing is he's right-handed. He's right-handed, and that tape's on his right pinky now. Oh, he finally hit the rim, but it still went in. So, good for him.
One minute
to go. Nighthawks by one. Ray Bergeson around to Biggie. Biggie finds Aaron Murphy in the short corner. Aaron's going to go one-on-one against Anderson. Quickly to the baseline side. Oh, soft off the glass.
Well done with
Murphy.
The left.
And just like early in the game when he was missing those shots, he was going quick.
Yeah.
And that was so patient.
Yeah.
It's a 30-second timeout. 45.1 seconds is the reset here.
Now we're going to see some offense, defense substitutions as Yaru Harvey comes back in for the Nighthawks for Gabe Murphy. Going to protect the three-point line, which SPU is so prolific at.
From a foul perspective, True Allen, Christian Rose, and Gabe Murphy have three. Everyone else is really only even Easton Reagan has two, and then it's one for Aaron and one for Jalen Fox. So Nighthawks are in great shape from a foul perspective. They do actually still have one to give. Nope, the next one will be 1-1. So both teams are, NNU will be in the double bonus. Nighthawks are not extending full, but they're going to force SPU to pick it up. And we're back underway. Here's Z. They vacate. They screen down for Anderson.
Great anticipation. Absolute great anticipation by Christian Rose to see where that play was headed. And did a great job of poking that ball away.
What that looked like to me, that looked like that was scouted.
Absolutely.
So credit to the assistant coaches down there in Hawkins who were breaking down the tape, because that really looked like he knew exactly what was coming.
You can know it and not execute it, but they knew it and executed it that time.
So first free throw is missed. So this free throw will push it to a two-possession game if Allen can knock it home. Tell you the one thing I've appreciated tonight since, you know, during the preseason you don't get to see a full GNAC officiating crew working, is tonight the amount of off-ball just talking and preventative officiating that's happened.
Mm-hmm.
And it's fun to see that again. Oh, it's missed by True Allen. Just still a one-possession game with 27 seconds to go. Shot clock is not a factor. Yep, foul on Ray Bergeson. So that'll be one plus the bonus. And I believe it's Moriarty going to the line.
Number five, Ray Bergeson, his first 2007. Owen Moriarty.
76% free throw shooter. Owen Moriarty, a 6'2 sophomore out of Seattle, went to O'Day High School.
Oh, wow.
First one is up and good. Timeout to Coach Hawkins. As he brings them. Looks like Christian Rose came out of the free throw lane a little tender on an ankle, so that brings Jalen Fox into the game. It's a full timeout. We'll take a break. We'll be right back as the Nighthawks lead it by two. Moriarty at the line for his second free throw. He's got 7 points tonight and 2 rebounds. Trace Evans leads the way on the boards for Shell Pacific with 8. Second free throw is good. So substitution. As we've got the all ball handling crew in now against the we've got a question.
With the book. Oh, possession.
Yeah, it should be NNU basketball after the last jump ball was on that tip by Aaron Murphy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So here is Biggie. Ray goes long. They run a play used to call football. There's Jalen Fox. He's going to take care of it and get around the corner, and Anderson fouls Jalen Fox. So
burned a few seconds off the clock there.
Yep.
Before the foul occurred.
Fox will go to the free throw line. They'll clear the lane for the first one. Left-handed free throw is good. Timeout called by Coach Fazio. It'll be a full timeout. 17 seconds to go. Let's take a look at some statistics here tonight. The second half has picked up the offensive pace a little bit. At this point, second half shooting 41.5% for the Nighthawks. Nighthawks have only taken 3 3-point shots this half. They've got 1 of 3, been very under control. 8 of 13 from the line so far. On the other side, Seattle Pacific, 45.5% from the floor. They have made 5 3-pointers this half, so that's been how they have stayed in the basketball game. A couple
big ones. 13 of 14 from the free throw line. Eight of those, of course, coming from Anderson.
Yep.
And Nighthawks, 9 of 15 from the free throw line.
Yep.
And if you make the critical ones down the stretch and prevent the three-pointer.
Yep.
Good chance for the Nighthawks, and I'm very comfortable with Jalen Fox at the free throw line.
One of the few times that the Nighthawks have gotten out-rebounded this year, they're down 31-36. About the only time you make exception with that is if you shoot a really high percentage.
And
but,
if you'd told me that Gabe Murphy would have 4 points and 3 rebounds.
Right.
And Nighthawks would be up by 2 with 17
sure.
seconds to go, I'd say, really?
Which is a credit to our depth and also a credit to Coach Fazio and their game plan.
Mm-hmm.
You know, similarly, the way Anderson has 13 and he was only 6, and only had 6 at halftime. So, huge free throw by Jalen Fox makes it a 3-point game. Doesn't that make it 53?
Yeah, it does.
Okay. I don't. It's not on the scoreboard, though.
Nope.
So we need to. Wasn't it 52? I'm pretty certain that. Yeah, Josh is going to fix this. We're missing a point on the scoreboard. So there we go. We got it. 53-50. And so there right there is, we've now determined what Coach Hawkins' lifetime philosophy is when you're up by 3. Do you foul or do you not foul? So we now will check the box that the first time we've seen it, he fouled.
Yep. So. If you're SPU, there's still plenty of time, so you make this one and
quick foul.
Try and get a steal foul game.
Yep. The only way the slipper breaks on this is if he misses the free throw. So he makes both free throws. Substitution, Theo McMillan is back in, and they continue to substitute back. Yaru's back in, Aaron Murphy out. Now we're gonna go all players out of bounds. One goes long, one goes. Biggie's coming back for it. Here's True Allen, he's able to get it. Lutonen tips it out of bounds. Looks like they're going to have a video review of that tip. So we'll see. I'm not sure there's going to be a very big, knowing the position of the camera.
Is under review.
Yeah, Coach Hawkins wants to know if he can run the baseline, which he will not be able to do.
Right.
The position of the camera where the replay camera is at center court on the far side of the gym. So that
will be a tough angle.
Be a tough angle
to get a clear shot. Is this one of those scenarios, Craig, where what was called on the floor, there has to be indisputable evidence?
I mean, if you're Ed Hockley, I think. I would most definitely say, I don't know what the Division II verbiage is right now when it comes to instant replay criteria, but I would think for sure that has to be what it is.
I would think so.
Especially with, you know, I know they can zoom in on the iPad and get pretty, it's HD video. I mean, it's a really good, but when you get into the corner or you get up against, especially with maybe the basket being in the way.
It's so close enough to where they're bringing in the third official.
Well, that's part of their protocol. So they always go in and. I would think at this juncture in the game, like you said, where it's a pivotal call, it would have to be pretty evident that it's off the other player.
They are spending a lot of time looking at it.
Right. No, I think they're actually just watching YouTube. I can see over the...
Well.
Nighthawks will be back here on Saturday afternoon and evening with a doubleheader against Montana State Billings. Men's game will tip off at 7:30. Carrie and I will be here to bring it to you. So if you want to come out in person and you're listening here in Nampa, women's game's at 5:15, men's game's at 7:30. Boy, this call might be going the other way. They're having a lot of discussion. Either that or they're figuring out what the game clock should be set out.
And in U-ball.
After review, it'll be Nighthawks ball.
Yeah, and that's the one thing that when they're working on that review.
They're looking at the clock.
Yep, exactly. A little bit easier for them on this one since the shot clock isn't in action. So NNU has the basketball. He cannot move. He's stationary. He can pivot, but he cannot run the baseline. Nighthawks in a box set, two runners on the baseline. Ray Bergeson with it. They're going to set the screen. Here comes True Allen. They're going to foul True right away, which they do. Nighthawks lead it by one. 8.2 seconds, which is an eternity.
True Allen.
Sure feels like it.
I got to get up early tomorrow. I mean, come on. We need True to knock these home. First one is good.
Christian Rose back on the floor. Owen Moriarty checks in.
Substitutions. Knocks home the second one. So will they stay with the foul? Nope, tipped it out of bounds. You might ask for the review.
Timeout
on the floor for Seattle Pacific. I mentioned the game on Saturday night where the Nighthawks will welcome Montana State Billings. MSU Billings going into tonight was atop the GNAC with the Nighthawks, 2-0 overall and 8-4. Looking past next this Saturday, next weekend, the Nighthawks will make the trip to Alaska Fairbanks and Anchorage. So going to Alaska on January 11th, there will probably be a little chilly for the Nighthawks. They have three in a row, the Alaska schools, and then they'll have a one-week break and play Saturday with at Anchorage and then at Central Washington that following Saturday. I was going to take a look at the GNAC website to get to see what the score is with Billings up at Central Washington. That game tipped off a little over an hour ago. So back to the sideline out of bounds. Right now, Billings is leading 45-41 up at Central Washington.
Definitely got to watch Anderson and Lutinen coming off of screens.
Moriarty with the basketball. Here comes Lutinen. They lob it underneath to Anderson. It's loose. Kicked it out. Oh, and a turnover as Lutinen missed it. Who's on the floor? Is that Biggie on the floor? Did he come off a screen?
Yeah, he got clocked.
I didn't get to see it. Let's see if there's a replay to play for us here.
It was a screen by Trace Evans, I think.
Gotcha. And he probably turned and didn't see it. But he's up. He's up and okay. At this point, he looks more like annoyed teenager than he does injured basketball player.
So,
you know that look? You know, when you want, could you take those shoes?
They are taking this to a review.
They're probably looking for, see if it's flagrant or, yeah. Which by the temperament of the players,
I don't think it is.
Because I'm guessing that Biggie would have had a little more animation, so to speak, if it would have been.
And it didn't look like any of the other players were
upset about it.
Fired up about it.
Right. So. Either way, it's going to come to the Nighthawks as the ball was turned over. They tried to tip it out to Lutinen, but he went baseline side, and the pass went towards half court.
Yeah, it looked like they were going to throw the lob.
Right.
And then the kick out.
Yep.
And it looked like Lutinen was going to have a look.
Yeah. Oh, replay. Looks like I don't think there's any. Looks like there's nothing there. Like you said, I'm guessing that he just turned around and ran into a screen, and there was no call out for it.
After review, ball is out of bounds. Nighthawks ball.
So, taking a look at the MSUB score, they're up 4 with 15 minutes to go in the game at Central Washington. So we could potentially have 2-3-0 teams if the Nighthawks can hold on here and
take care of the ball.
Yeah.
Long pass into Biggie, but it's stolen away. Buzzers off. Three-quarter court shot falls short, and your Nighthawks get the GNAC victory here at home. 55-52. You know, Kerry, the one statistic I see on the stat sheet that screams at me, 6 turnovers for the game for the Nighthawks.
Yeah, that's impressive. That's impressive.
Taking care of the basketball does a lot for you on the scoreboard.
It does.
So we'll sign off tonight as the Nighthawks pick up the 55-52 win over Seattle Pacific. For Kerry Cook and the staff that brought us the basketball game tonight, I'm Craig Stensgaard. Join us on Saturday night as we welcome Montana State Billings right back here at the Johnson Sports Center. Good night.